welcome back everyone, I am a wolf in every game, bringing you Paragon. Finally, I know I've talked about this game a couple of times in my previous videos, but I can finally record it since NVIDIA updated, so I use their, I think it's called, NVIDIA Shadowplay to record my gameplays, and we're going to focus on Iggy and Scorch because I got, for playing the betas, they gave me a special little promo, I guess you can call it, where they gave me, it's kind of hard to explain without going into full detail. Essentially, you level up heroes in this game, like you level up people and other heroes and gods, since I play Smite, other heroes and gods and other MOBAs. Well, they have a whole system, which I shall show you real quick. Heroes, also play a lot of Sparrow, ADC's rule, Iggy and Scorch,
there we go.
So, they let me instantly start the Master Challenge, which gave me access to their Challenger skin. This is it. I know it's kind of blurry, I'm sorry guys. NVIDIA won't let me record other than in their suggested settings. But right now I have him at level 3. I also get double XP on him, so I've been playing him for a little bit. Like, there's literally two matches with him. I'm gonna be playing more with him. You probably see some gameplays. I'm gonna try to post more gameplays throughout the week. Since it ends Tuesday, so I'm gonna get as much as I can. It's actually gonna be Iggy and Scorch. I have a couple of decks, but yeah, back to this deck. I name it Oil Fire because oil fires are kind of hard to put out. And this is, well, based on that saying, it's kind of a stain build. So these are basic cards. I don't know if enough people show on their Paragon videos how to build decks and such. So yeah, we're just gonna go over that real quick. Consumables. You're most likely gonna sell them at some point throughout the game to get back card points, which maximize at 60 points. This shows 28, but that's not including my upgrades. It just includes the cards themselves and not the upgrades. So these cards equal 5 points. At some point during the game, I'll have 5 extra points. But I do not take on all the cards, since at the beginning of the game, you do start off with 3 points. A basic build would be Harvester Key, Health Potion, Mana Potion, or the 2 potions along with Scout's Ward. I have Bump Juice, just in case the enemy team seems to be a little bit aggressive, and I get rid of something to get 2 health potions, since I want to have high sustain in the lane. That rhymed. Okay, well, now onto these. I do play against Scorch under, what's it called? In the jungler build. Jungler. I play him as a jungler. Because fire turrets, they're amazing. And you'll be seeing that in the gameplay. I will go over that briefly, what's going on in the gameplay every now and then, but I won't commentate throughout the whole thing. But back to the build. So the Reaper's Key, it's much faster than the Harvester Key. Harvester Key places a Harvester in 6 seconds. Harvesters are really important. Harvesters give you extra CXP, card point experience, card experience, and that's help you build your decks faster. So yeah, 3-second Harvesters, very key. This Harvester Key also gives me extra stats. Little Lightning Bolt means, I keep moving my mouse. Little Lightning Bolt means, energy damage. Or Iggy and Scorch, caster hero, so I need more energy damage. That little knife symbol means crit chance. Is it crit chance or crit percentage? Let's see. Sorry, I'm actually having a brief moment. Crit chance, yeah, it's crit chance. We're gonna skip this one for now. Real quick, we're going on to the second card I would build, would be my drink, the spirits. Now, as you see here, I upgraded with 3 casts. I should have went over this real quickly. I'm doing badly at this. Forgive me, guys. The 3 casts give me 13 energy damage each. Those are my upgrades. And once fully upgraded, the Harvester Key gets 2 charges and will charge at base. Harvester Key recharges at base. The only way to get your passives is to fully upgrade your cards, by the way. Now, this one has cheap upgrades in it, because it gives me 100 health and 75 mana. I call that really good sustain, but it has a really unique passive of whenever I kill an enemy unit, which is either minions, towers, even works on towers, guys. And heroes, I get 5% of the killed unit's health. That's what I, okay, I said that right, cool. Oh wait, it's not towers. What was I healing off of? I just played the game and I'm confused. Anyways, so yeah, minions or players. So I get 5% of the health healed up on me. So that's a really good one, and since it's kind of expensive at 4, I put 3 cheap upgrades in it. This is the prime sustain card in this deck. It's really key for sustain. And it's corruption, which I'm just gonna go over this real quick. Like, my harvest key, see how it's purple is corruption, see how the bump juice is red. Igneous Course takes Fury and Corruption cards as their uniques. The gray cards are common, they can go to any, they're universal. They can go to any hero. Wellspring Staff, I know I'm throwing a lot of information. If you guys have any questions for me, remember to drop a comment below and I'll answer it to my best ability, or you can check out any of the YouTubers that are playing this game and they probably have better content on this. But anyways, yeah, so Wellspring Staff. This one's for my mana. Wellspring Staff gives me 6.5 energy damage, 75 mana, and once fully upgraded I get 13 more energy damage. So I put 3 advanced manas into this. That gives me a ton of mana, guys. Next, we go Staff of the Adamant. Not that one, this one. This one I put into health, the other one I put into to damage. Staff of the Adamant gives me 6.5 energy damage, 100 health. I put 3 greater health upgrades for 300. That's a lot of health, guys. Even on a mage, you gotta remember that. On this game, I must say, tanky mages are a real good thing. But damage mages, oh my gosh, they're scary. I have a damage mage build I will actually show you. Her name is Gadget, but we'll save that for another video. After this card, we go into Staff of the Adamant. Our damage Staff of the Adamant. We upgrade that with 3 major casts, give me 19.5 damage each. Fully upgraded, you know, gives me 13 more damage. And you can only have 5 cards on your hero at a time, so I know there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there's 7 cards. I will explain why in a second. So after that Staff of the second Staff of the Adamant, we'd go Pendulum of Lords. This one I put in just for cooldown reduction. Iggy and Scorch can throw out turrets. Having cooldown reduction on those turrets, you can have a line of them. I think it's up to 3 turrets at max rank. So beautiful. And then you throw out your oil and deal more damage. On sustain, these guys can still deal a ton of damage. And this is the first time I think I'm going over videos like this. So let's see. At this point, we're just gonna recap. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Am I counting right? Oh, I think I have 6 cards. I think you can have 6 cards on your hero at a time. I think I'm wrong about that 3 cards. No, that 5 cards thing. Because late game, you're probably not gonna need this anymore. I end up selling the Reaper's Key, which I don't think I can show in the video because I actually played against AI, because everyone and their butts wanted to play against Scorch on the competitive side, so I said screw it, I'll just play against AI so I can get this video up to show you guys. So you end up selling the Reaper's Key and picking up the Agoran Scepter. These names are kind of hard to pronounce. Now this one's kind of mixed and cheap, due to the fact that I was running out of card points, and I am max of 60 card points. I think I told you guys that. Always have a calculator handy when you're making these builds, by the way. So this one gives me a ton of more power, and once fully upgraded, I get a 50% crit bonus. Now, it's kind of pointless to have that crit bonus. I actually have this in here just for the power. I don't have any other cards that give me a good deal of power, honestly. I probably should replace this for, like, the Cryomancer disc. But I wanted... You know what? I just talked to myself into changing my own build right here in front of you guys. So we're gonna with the same cards, but that's actually a much better idea, since there is actually like no crit in this deck. But yeah. Oh, one more thing I need to go over. your... This is a Universal Prime card. If you guys played Smite or League of Legends, you know you had that one boss. Smite was the Fire Giant. League of Legends, I believe, was the Baron. You get a buff. This one's a little bit different. There's a... What's it called? It's called Or Prime Minion. It is on the map. It takes a group to kill it. You pick up an orb. You run it to a particular dunk location to drop it, and your whole team gets a buff. This is your buff. You can pick your buff out of three cards. You got Archmages, which is energy damage, Centurion, which is a tanky one, and Warlord, which is all physical damage. We're going with Archmagus, since we are a caster. But yeah, I hope you guys will enjoy the little gameplay. It's just one game. I could play plus to put up more. I will put up more, but not particularly showing off the build, just showing off the gameplay itself. And I hope you guys enjoy. So here we go, guys. I'm gonna just gonna give you a brief overview of Iggy and Scorch's abilities. So we have his Q, which is what I suggest upgrading first and all the way through. That is his flame turret, pretty much the bread and butter between on his kit. The flame turrets help you control a lane really well. Then they help you clear jungle camps very well. Oh my gosh, I'm doing so badly already in my commentary. Wow, this game actually looks much better than I expected when I recorded it. Playing it, it doesn't look this good, honestly. But the flame turrets at max level gets you 3. At the first rank, you can only have 1. I sometimes forget that. Now see, you can just throw it right in the middle of people, get in their way. It's a pretty handy ability. It is E, which I recommend leveling up second. I believe it's called Oil Spill. You throw it down, it deals damage if you hit an enemy hero, but you can also light it with your ultimate, your auto attack, and a flame turret can light it, and it deals dot damage and extra damage. Then there's his basic attack, just throw a Molotov. Then we have the right click. No. Is that right click? Yeah, that's right click. I'm so confused. So we have his right click, which is Oil Slick, I believe. You get a movement speed buff, and you leave up, you leave behind a trail of oil. Ugh, I'm doing so bad on my commentary. Must be late. So, you leave a trail of oil, you like that. Simple. It's not really that hard to play, honestly. They have him under intermediate, but I think it's because turret placement is so important for you. Now we have his ultimate, which is probably my favorite ultimate in the game, to be honest. I forgot what it's called. Flame Belch. So, he gives Scorch, or Scorch is the dinosaur he rides, a Molotov to swallow. As he like pretty much starts spewing flames afterwards, and then he lets out a large belch at the end that pushes back enemies. I use this whenever I see any of these enemies getting like too close and out of, oh my gosh, I had this all prepped and I can't remember what it's called now. My commentary is just so bad today. Out of position. When they get out of position, I just let loose flame belch. It burns them down with steady DPS and then pushes them back. I try to aim them to go back towards my turrets, and you see right now I'm trying to pick up the what's it called? Yeah, the red buff. The red buff does extra damage and gives me extra movement speed when I'm in combat. The reason I want this buff is mainly because I don't have a lot of damage in this build. And, what's it called? I feel like in this game, if your jungler is not using a, buff, then he's not really jungling very well. Also, I do make a mistake in this game. When I pick up my Reaper's Key, I forget to fully upgrade it. Always fully upgrade your items before... Ow, I have a pain in my side. Always fully upgrade your items before you move on to your next item, because you want that extra benefit from them, especially with your Reaper's Keys and your special keys and your special wards, because if you don't fully upgrade them, they don't, some of them have this effect that they don't recharge when you run, go back to base. It's kind of important, especially if you want to jungle. So yeah, I think I said everything I actually needed to about Icky and Scorch. Pretty simple hero. Just make sure you get your flame turrets in good positions. Remember to apply your oil. Your oil should probably go first. You should probably throw your oil down first, or actually, I don't think it matters if you throw it down first. I don't think it slows them or anything. I would actually like it to slow. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the rest of the gameplay. I'm only going to show key moments considering how long the gameplay is, and I don't want this video to drag. If you do like what you see, remember to like, comment, subscribe. I will be posting more Paragon for the rest of the week. We'll see whatever I get. I'll probably try to post every day, honestly. And if you guys dislike the video, just make sure you let me know in the comment section below. And remember to actually let me know you dislike the video by clicking that dislike button. But please click the like button. I really like when you click the like button. Oh my gosh, I'm rambling again. Someone play music.
tower destroyed.
Hold me close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us.